sta arrivando uomo nero. Black, white, the same blood that is flowing inside. The difference is zero. So why should you tell your child that black?
Yo guys, welcome back to another video, wherever you are. Special greetings to you, and don't forget, if today is your first time, please do me a favor by subscribing to the channel. Also, don't forget to hit on the notification bell. Whenever you draw a video, you can also get it and watch. And don't forget, this channel is all about education, entertainment and documents. Today I'm here with this episode where I'm going to tell you how one of our brother has been killed, and then they have not made justice to this our brother. And also, Italia Campania ambulance are not enough for patients to even transport them from their houses to the hospital. So guys, without wasting my time, let's do this thing together. As I said before, one of our brother immigrant who was living down there, who was just killed, just a painful kill. One man just killed this guy just for nothing, you understand? They were living down there. He was one of the laborers, and then I think they were going to gather some things to, make place, you know, down there where they are even sleeping. Is just make some tent and they are sleeping inside, you understand? Because life, you want life to move on, you understand? So anything that you do to survive, you have to do what? To survive. So they went one day where they are going to pick for some old things and other that, and then this man just killed this our brother. You can put his picture here, you understand? So this is the guy you are seeing who they killed 2 years ago, 2018, that they killed this guy, and we are in 2020, you understand? So that means 2 years ago. And then the murder has been found, or the person who killed this guy has been found, you understand? And then they gave this man 22 years imprisonment, and now we are seeing this man outside. Put the murder also here, put him here, you understand? Now this guy is here. Somebody that they have given 22 years imprisonment, now the guy is outside there. So now the friend of the guy who died is saying that maybe what happened can happen again, because you cannot tell me that you have given somebody 22 years imprisonment and now the person is walking outside after 1 week, you understand? That means they haven't done justice to this our brother. So this is going to tell you that blacks, they don't value us, because if this thing was to be black person did this to white person, you would have go directly to life imprisonment without coming back, you understand? But because this one is Italian or is somebody white, different from black, you understand? That means you have to survive. They need to give you some opportunities. So now this guy is outside there walking around, you understand? Meanwhile, you are saying you are giving 22 years imprisonment, and now this guy is walking around, somebody who just caused murder, you understand? That is what happened to Willie's own. Maybe these people, they will just leave those people just for some few days. In the beginning of the issue, they will come out and they will be doing like they like you people, you understand? They'll be doing like they want to put justice to where justice lies. But 2-3 days, they will forget everything. This guy just died 2 years ago, and now the person has been found. It's not that they have not seen somebody who has killed him. They have seen the person who has killed him. A friend saw this thing, you understand? Even that friend or that so-called friend now is afraid if this man will do something to him, because he saw him directly killing that guy, you understand? So guys, let's go and watch that video. When we are back, we will give you the rest of the update. So
non si dà pace Fofana. Solo una settimana fa aveva creduto che il suo amico Soumaila Sakho avrebbe potuto avere giustizia, e invece ieri la doccia fredda. Antonio Pontoriero, condannato in primo grado a 22 anni per omicidio volontario, è già uscito di prigione. Il tribunale del riesame gli ha concesso i domiciliari.
Io penso Soumaila è morto due volte.
È morto una seconda volta. C'è amarezza e incredulità nelle sue parole.
Qualcuno che è condannato a 22 anni e ha assassinato le persone. È come una settimana deve lasciare andare a casa. Io non ne capisco questo modo.
Lui è stato uno dei testimoni chiave al processo. Quel 2 giugno del 2018 era insieme a Soumaila e a un altro compagno. Erano andati a prendere delle lamiere per la loro baracca a San Ferdinando, in un terreno abbandonato nel Vibonese. All'improvviso i colpi di fucile che lasciano a terra Soumaila. Lui ha visto tutto e ha subito puntato il dito contro l'assassino. Adesso ha paura, ha ucciso una volta, può farlo ancora, dice, ricordando il suo amico che si batteva per i diritti dei braccianti.
Faremo di tutto affinché sia fatta giustizia e non sia infangata per la seconda volta la memoria di Soumaila.
Guys, I hope you have seen the video. So that is it I have for you for this our brother. But you can write rest in peace to this our brother wherever you are. Just type rest in peace for me so that this the soul of this our brother will rest in peace. You understand, guys? Let's move on to the other story. You know, Campania, Napoli. Now they say ambulances are not available. The 118, that is 118. If you have any problem, you can call them and then they will come and pick you to the hospital. You understand? They are the ambulance. But now they are saying these people are not available. Even if you want to call them, maybe if you need them about 1 hour time, you need to start calling early before you will get them, because you can call them like 40 minutes and nobody is going to respond to your call. You understand? And what they are telling us now, they say people are calling them day in, day out, especially in that Campania area. So if you want to call them, you need to start calling early. Maybe if somebody want to fall sick and the person start, you need to start calling the person that moment. The time the case will increase, they will arrive to your doorsteps and then they will carry the person to the hospital. You understand? They did this and one of our sister lost his brother just because they did not come early in time. They called the ambulances and they delayed them. You understand? Because if you call and then they see that somebody call and they see, they will put, now this is where they will do scale of preference. You understand? Now they have to look at the one which is very who is dying first. You understand? They have to do scale of preference and see who is having the most problem or who is affected most, so that they will attend to the person. It's not that they are not working. You will go to where they park the ambulance car and you not even see one ambulance over there. That means these people are working. You understand? So people are calling and they're not getting them. Some people can even call like 40 minutes but nobody is responding because they are busy attending to some people. So this is the wahala coming from Campania area. So it's very difficult for you to get ambulances, and everybody is calling ambulance because the cases over there are rising. Now I think they are in the red zone and then that is dangerous. You understand? So wherever you are, guys, protect yourself and let's avoid ourselves from this virus. You understand? So let's go and watch that video. When we are back, we will give you the rest of the update.
Mio padre, la prima ambulanza l'abbiamo chiamata il 24 ottobre, l'ambulanza che l'ha ricoverato è stato il 6 novembre. Mi diceva che non riusciva a contattare nessuno del medico di base, un medico di base che ha degli orari ridicoli, respirava a fatica, enorme fatica.
Aveva cercato anche l'ossigeno, è arrivato dopo parecchio tempo.
La figlia Ipazia e l'amico Mario non si danno pace. Francesco Ruotolo, 74 anni, noto attivista nel rione sanità, nessuna patologia precedente, è morto così di Covid, due giorni dopo essere finalmente arrivato all'ospedale Cardarelli.
Il servizio della regione Campania.
Il numero verde della regione squilla per 10, 30, 40 minuti senza risposta. Il simbolo dell'abbandono dei cittadini, tutto ricade sui 118.
Il motivo per cui, nel caso in cui non rispondessero, è da chiedere alla regione, però sono tutte poi telefonate che saturano il sistema 118.
Qui all'ASL 2 Napoli Nord le ambulanze sono sempre tutte fuori.
La centrale operativa dell'ASL Napoli 2 serve 1.100.000 abitanti, disponibili 23 mezzi, che sono ovviamente pochi rispetto alle necessità.
Per di più metà degli operatori del centralino ora sono positivi, gli altri devono sopperire con turni doppi. Nelle altre ASL la situazione è simile, troppo poco per riempire il vuoto che i cittadini sentono attorno.
Combattevo per questo tipo di ingiustizie qui, combattevo per le ingiustizie sanitarie, i diritti degli ultimi, diritti di chi è dimenticato, e lui è stato dimenticato.
I hope you have seen that video from Campania. So that is what is going on from that Campania region, you understand? So I think the virus is increasing. So wherever you are, as I said before, protect yourself. If you are moving out, your nose mask, your face mask, you try and have your thing, you understand? And then a lot of workplaces are closed, you understand? Just be in doorstep. If you need something, if you are like family, just go and get it bunch, you understand? And come and put it in one corner and then you will start enjoying, because you don't need to be going out Just like that, you understand? So guys, I think I'll end today's video here, and then if you have not subscribed yet, you know now, just do me that favor by subscribing to the channel. Also, don't forget to hit on that notification bell. Whenever you drop any video, I think you will be notified, and then you will know what is going on in the country and even beyond. So guys, till we meet again in the next video, stay safe and stay blessed. Bye bye.